When you type someone, don't think of the functions as eight individual separate functions, but as four axes or rods. One of Jung's influences was the Greek philosopher Heraclitus, who believed in the unity of opposites. He is credited with saying, as one translation puts it, "The road up and the road down are the same road." We see this idea reflected in the dichotomies of Jung's typology. SE is the opposite of NI, and NE is the opposite of SI, but because they are true opposites, they don't operate independent of each other, but are rather two opposing poles on the same rod, or two different directions on the same road. NI is not an individual idea that is very different from SE, rather, it exists by virtue of SE. It is the opposite motion from SE, and therefore has no meaning without SE. Likewise, SE has no meaning without NI. It is like with any pair of opposites. If there is no concept of white, then we can't comprehend that everything is actually black. Blackness would be without meaning if we can't have things otherwise. As such, no matter which direction on the road is preferred, there are some characteristics of the road itself that manifest in a person's psyche. With that said, I will offer the following characteristics typical of each axis. The SENI axis represents an intense perception, one that tends to overcommit or overanalyze one area, but can gain a surprising depth of insight. For instance, the INTJ's tunnel vision drive, the ENTJ's brutality and directness in debate, the INFJ's devotion to creating a holistic system, the ESTP's directness in overcoming challenges, or the ISTP's incredible focus. The motion I imagine here begins as narrow and pinpointed at the object, representing the direct focus on the object itself. This expands as we retreat into the subject's psyche, where that one object is expanded into a fuzzy associative image that is compared with the hundreds of other impressions and fragments in the psyche. In this way, the SENI axis is intensive, or magnifying, taking inspiration from objects themselves and figuring out all of their subjective possibilities, rather like an overhead projector displaying an enlarged but fuzzier image of the object. With ESTPs and ESFPs, the focus is on the object itself, while with INFJs and INTJs, the focus is on the fuzzy image, the subjective possibilities. The NESI axis represents a multifaceted, sweeping perception that tends to undercommit and bounces around, but which gains a surprising breadth of insight. For instance, the ENTP's multifaceted inquiries, or the INTP's search for multiple applications for one abstract system, or the ENFP's wanderlust and resourcefulness, or the ISTJ's thorough waterproofing of their principles. The motion I imagine here begins as stretched, fuzzy but associative, representing the indirect, intuitive relationship with objects. This narrows and focuses as we retreat into the subject's psyche, where the stretched sweep is pinpointed and directly examined, comparing it to other directly examined impressions. In this way, the NESI axis is meticulous and examining, making detailed and thorough record of their creative, associative perceptions of the world, rather like a telescope that takes a fuzzy, distant image and shrinks and sharpens it. With the ENTPs and ENFPs, the focus is on these creative perceptions, while with ISTJs and ISFJs, the focus is on the recorded details and thoroughness. The TEFI axis represents the road between logical judgments based on objective data to valuations of things based on subjective impressions. It is the motion between an outside world of outlines to an internal world of shading and values, or a cold, uncaring outside world compared to the warmth within the individual. To illustrate, the TEFI axis represents the struggle of a lone individual against a freezing wilderness, employing whatever means necessary to survive and doing everything they can to keep warm, to make their warmth known in the world and push back the encroaching ice. It is individuating. For instance, the INTJ's image is a lone visionary. The ESTJ's prioritization of responsibility over anyone else's values. The INFP's championing of their dream world, or the ESFP's spontaneity and love of performing. The FETI axis represents the road between valuations based on objective information to logical judgments based on subjective impressions. It is the motion between an outside world of shading and values to an internal world of outlines, or a hot, sultry, caring outside world compared to the distinguishing coolness within the individual. However, to illustrate the FETI axis, I'll use a different image. It's rather like someone lost in a foreign country that speaks an entirely foreign language, and the journey of discovering and integrating the logic of the language into oneself so that you can experience the warmth of true interaction and join with the people. The struggle to balance the inner ice with the outer sun to match the temperature of those around you. The axis is thus harmonizing. For instance, the ENTP's inquiries to discover objective truth, or the INTP's relentless abstraction, the INFJ's holistic theories of the world, and the ISTP's quest to master a technique. So, to summarize, the SENI axis is intense and magnifying, like a projector shining a larger blurred image of an object. The NESI axis is meticulous and examining, like a telescope shrinking and sharpening a blurry distant object. The TEFI axis is individuating, struggling to survive in a cool wilderness and manifest their inner warmth in the world. The FETI axis is harmonizing, lost in a foreign land, trying to learn the language so that they can enjoy the warmth of honest interaction with people and comfort of a culture.